Israel Aerospace Industries unveiled a new air-launched variant of its LORA ballistic missile on June 6, a design the company claims will enhance Israel's ability to provide long-range strike at rapid speed. The LORA has its origins in a ground-based long-range artillery weapon system that the company demonstrated at ranges up to 400 kilometers back in 2020. The new air-launched version was rolled out for the first time at the ILA Berlin Air Show. The air-launched version extends the range of the relevant targets as the missile is launched from the maximum range of the fighters, he added. Asked which platforms the system could be launched from, Maman said it would work with all modern fighter platforms or potential carriers, and also transporters with hardpoints. Israel has for years launched long-range strikes off its fleet of F-15, F-16, and F-35 Iater fighter jets. As with the Air LORA, the Rampage is compatible with the S-16 and other advanced fourth-generation fighter types, and not just Western-built models. The air-launched ballistic missile was recently inducted by India's Air Force and Navy Russian-built Su-30 MKI and MiG-29K fighter jets. Britain is also considering buying some Rampage missiles to replace the stocks of air-launched Storm Shadow cruise missiles it sent to Ukraine. While the cost of the Rampage is unclear, it is believed to be less than $1 million per unit, much cheaper than the Storm Shadow's $3 million price tag. Aside from affordability, another selling point Israel may hope attracts buyers for missiles like the Air LORA and Rampage is their capability and survivability against strategic air defenses. Israel reportedly selected the Rampage for that particular strike, given the presence of an advanced long-range Russian S-300 in the vicinity. Israel needed a missile that it could safely fire from a standoff range. The Rampage fit the bill. Furthermore, while easy to detect, the missile's supersonic speed makes it hard to intercept. Its reported combat debut on that day was a success. More recently, Israel demonstrated its capability to target an advanced variant of the S-300, Iran's S-300 PMU-2, using an air-launched ballistic missile. The system was demonstrated on an S-16 for a fire test, the company said in a separate statement. However, IAI did not respond to inquiries about the range of the weapon, the potential customers, and whether it was operational or combat-proven. According to company literature, the missile can be used in all weather conditions and can strike targets if the target location changes during the airborne mission flight. The company described the weapon as ideal for striking high-quality and well-protected targets such as command centers, Air Force bases, infrastructure, and naval vessels in dense littorals. IAI also claims the system is easily integrated onto existing avionics. The weapon has different types of warheads and features high survivability with advanced immune ANS/GNS navigation and strong anti-jamming capabilities, allowing for 24/7 operation in extreme weather conditions and highly contested battlefields. That navigation system is an aspect IAI hyped up through its announcement, perhaps a sign of acknowledgement that the modern electronic warfare situation means GPS weapons are too vulnerable to jamming. The company statement notes that the high survivability of the missile is also achieved by endgame trajectory shaping and 90 degrees attack angle. Israel historically has not developed a large number of long-range missiles, but it does has a few key systems in inventory. It developed the Jericho family beginning in the 1960s, and more recently, ground-based missiles called Extra and Mars. In terms of air-launched long-range missiles, Israel possesses the Rampage, which was one of the missiles reports suggested may have been used in a retaliatory attack on Iran in April. Rampage was co-developed by Israel Military Industries, since acquired by Elbit Systems and IAR. Israel also uses the air-launched Sparrow, which was developed by Rafael Advanced Defense Systems. Rafael also makes a system called ROX, which is a long-range air-launched standoff missile. In terms of integration, IAI says that Air LORA has completed trials on the S-16 and that the weapon's design stresses that it can be seamlessly integrated into any aircraft as a standalone configuration or through existing avionics systems. Back in June 2020, when IAI demonstrated the ground-based version of the LORA, it was billed as a precise ballistic strike missile. In a trial at sea, the LORA struck a target at 90 kilometers and 400 kilometers. In its ground version, the weapon system was deployed on a ship in the open sea to comply with the safety requirements of trials of this type, IAI said at the time. The safety requirements at the time were due to COVID. The LORA system provides ballistic assault capabilities for multiple ranges with a precision level of 10 meters CEP. However, the appearance of the new weapon is further evidence of something of a renaissance for air-launched ballistic missiles. While these weapons have a long history of development, they are now generating considerable interest not just in Israel, but also in China, Russia, and elsewhere. The new missile would appear to be a very useful option to expand the air-launched precision standoff strike capability of many different nations, offering a high degree of flexibility, fast reaction time, and the ability to penetrate most enemy air defenses. It would also seem that it rounds out Israel's still relatively new portfolio on adapted air-launched artillery rockets and ballistic missile weapon systems as the heaviest and hardest hitting of the lot. If you enjoy content like this, please go ahead and like and subscribe to this video, because I appreciate all your support.